إله إلا الله.
إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستهديه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا، من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدًا عبده ورسوله. اللهم صلِّ وسلِّم وزد وبارك على نبينا محمدٍ وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. عباد الله، يقول الله تعالى في كتابه العزيز بعد أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم: يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله ولتنظر نفس ما قدمت لغد واتقوا الله إن الله خبير بما تعملون. ثم أما بعد، my dear brothers and sisters, today we will continue our topic, imagiation. This is one way from the ways to convince and to guide your kids, your youth, to let them think about al-akhirah, to let them believe that the day of judgment will come to us. We will see it. We will live that day. We will see the adab of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and the rahmah of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Imagination. Imagine what will happen that day, which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has told us and Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam has taught us. We took that there is one side from the day of judgment, from the sides of day of judgment, side of يوم التناد, the day of calling. There is group of people will call other, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will call the messengers. We said last khutbah, there is 10 scenes, 10 calls will happen that day. Number one, calling from Allah to the messengers. What did you do? Number two, calling from Allah to those who denied the messengers. Number three, call from Allah to those who accepted the messengers and their messages. Number four, calling from people of hellfire to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, to the angels, to ash-shaytan. They will call each other. Al-mustad'afin wal-mustakbirin, people of power and weak people. They will talk together. They will call each other. And today, inshallah, we will take, bi-idhnillahi ta'ala, the call which will happen from people of hellfire to people of Jannah. They will call them. They will try to talk with them. Yeah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala yaqul في سورة الأعراف: ونادى أصحاب النار أصحاب الجنة أن أفيضوا علينا من الماء أو مما رزقكم الله. People of hellfire will call people of Jannah. Oh people of Jannah, just give us something from your water or something from that Allah has provided you. أفيضوا علينا من الماء أو مما رزقكم الله. يقول العلماء والمفسرون that الماء, we know the ماء, أو مما رزقكم الله, from that which Allah has provided you. What is that? They said the provision of Allah in Jannah, much. There are many things that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will give it to the people of Jannah. Among this stuff, water, food, And there is many things. فالعلماء said that مما رزقكم الله, here they will talk about food. Give us water or food. أفيدوا علينا. الإفاضة من الكثرة. أفيد means many, much. Just give us much water. We need it. أفيدوا علينا من الماء أو مما رزقكم الله. Then the people of Jannah will answer them. قالوا إن الله حرمهما على الكافرين. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has forbidden this stuff, food and drink, to the disbelievers. There is no food, there is no water. طبعاً after they خلاص give up. They talk with each other, they talk with الشيطان, they talk with angels, they talk with themselves, with their limbs. There is no response. This is the last call from them to call people of Jannah. They will call with their relatives. Like what Ibn Abbas radiallahu anhu said. They will talk with their relatives. Oh my son, you are in Jannah. Just give me some water. And the son will talk with his father. Oh my dad, just give me some from that which you have in Jannah. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in Surah Abasa, يَوْمَ يَفِرُّ الْمَرْءُ مِنْ أَخِيهِ وأمه وأبيه وصاحبته وبنيه لكل امرئ منهم يومئذ شأن يغنيه. What that means? يوم يفر. الفرار here like run. They will just run away. The brother will run away from his brother. The father will run away from his son. The man will run away from his wife. وصاحبته وبنيه. Why, ya Allah? Allah has answered. لكل امرئ منهم يومئذ شأن يغني. Each one of them in that day has something, has his affairs, has his sins, has his deeds, has his own things. لكل امرئ منهم يومئذ شأن يغني. Allahu Akbar. This is the eighth call from people of hellfire to people of Jannah. The ninth, good talk, good call from the angels to the people of paradise. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gather us among them. إنه على كل شيء قدير. يقول سبحانه وتعالى في سورة الزمر, great آيات, وسيق الذين اتقوا إلى الجنة زمرا. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will lead the believers to let them go to Jannah زمرا, groups. حتى إذا جاءوها وفتحت أبوابها. When they arrive to Jannah, Allah said wa. المفسرين here says that وَفُتِحَتْ means وَقَدْ فُتِحَتْ. يعني when they arrive to Jannah, they will found it opened. وَفُتِحَتْ أَبْوَابُهَا. In the ayah of people of hellfire, when Allah said, وَسِيقَ الَّذِينَ كَفَرُوا إِلَى جَهَنَّمَ زُمَرَ حَتَّى إِذَا جَاءُوهَا فُتِحَتْ أَبْوَابُهَا. There is no wow here. When the groups of hellfire going to hellfire, when they arrive, Allah will open hellfire for them. Allah will open the doors of hellfire for them when they arrive. But people of Jannah, Allah will open the doors before they arrive. It's just honor for them. وَفُتِحَتْ أَبْوَابُهَا وَقَالَ لَهُمْ خَزَنَتُهَا. The angels will call the believers. سَلَامٌ عَلَيْكُمْ طِبْتُمْ فَادْخُلُوهَا خَالِدِينَ. Peace be upon you. طِبْتُمْ. May you will be happy. May you will be blessed. فَادْخُلُوهَا خَالِدِينَ. Come in. Forever. خالدين. Allahu Akbar. This is the time of opening the doors of Jannah. Are we imagine that? Who will go to Jannah? Who will enter Jannah? We have to ask ourselves. You will not enter Jannah without sacrificing in dunya. You will not enter Jannah without doing good deeds in dunya. مَنْ لَمْ يَشُمُّ رَائِحَةَ الْجَنَّةَ فِي الدُّنْيَا لَنْ يَشُمَّهَا فِي الْآخِرَةِ If you don't smell the Jannah in dunya, you will not go there. You will not smell there. The Jannah, Jannah in dunya, al-ibadah, al-amal al-salih. The Jannah of dunya is worshipping Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make good deeds. I'm advising myself and you and our youth. If your dad comes to you and talk with you about Jannah, about Siyam, about reciting Quran, don't be bored. He is telling this because he is awaring and he just awakening you from that day which you will live. Like what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, what Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, طبتم طبتم فادخلوها خالدين. May you are blessed. Just go, enter, come in, خالدين forever. There is great hadith narrated by Abu Hurairah radiallahu anhu, collected in al-Imam al-Tirmidhi wa ibn Majah wa ibn Hibban. Tirmidhi wa ibn Majah, hadith Hasan, ibn Hibban, hadith sahih, authentic hadith in ibn Hibban. And Hasan, good hadith in ibn Majah wa al-Tirmidhi. That, man aada maridhan, aw zara akhan lahu fi Allah, nadathu al-malaika, tibta, وطاب ممشاك وتبوأت الجنة منزلا. The angels are calling those who are visiting the sick people, those who are visiting their brothers in the bath of Allah. The malaika are calling them in dunya first. طبتم وطاب ممشاكم. May you will be happy. May you will be blessed. May you will reward inshallah a good position in Jannah, a good place in paradise. They were saying this in dunya. If you make all these good deeds, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will let the malaika say this in al-akhirah. When you are going and entering Jannah, the malaika will say, طبتم, same thing. طبتم فادخلوها خالدين. Are we imagine these scenes? Are we imagine these moments, which wallahi we will see it, wallahi we will watch it, wallahi we will live it. Are we imagine that? يوم التناد, the day of calling. This was the ninth one. Talking or calling from al-malaika to people of Jannah. I will, inshaAllah, talk about the last one after جلسة الاستراحة. أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله لي ولكم. إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونستهديه ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا. من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلن تجد له هاد. أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله. ثم أما بعد, يوم التناد, the day of calling, last scene, that القرآن والصيام, fasting and the reciting of القرآن, they will call the believers, they will call those who were fasting in dunya, those who were reciting Quran in dunya, wallahi they will call. Great hadith narrated by Amr ibn al-As radiallahu anhu, collected in Musnad al-Imam Ahmad. Great hadith that as-siyam wal-Quran yashfa'an للعبد يوم القيامة. فيقول الصيام, أي ربي لقد منعته الطعام والشهوات في النهار فشفعني فيه. ويقول القرآن, أي ربي لقد منعته النوم في الليل فشفعني فيه. فيشفعان في العبد المؤمن. What that means, long hadith but great hadith, that الصيام والقرآن, fasting and the reciting of Al-Quran will help the good believers at the Day of Judgment. They will help. They will make shafa'ah. They will defend. They will say, Ay Rabbi. The Siyam will say, Oh Lord, لَقَدْ مَنَعْتُهُ. I have forbidden him from food and from lots in the days. Then شَفِّعْنِي فِيهِ. Let me help him. Let me defend him. Let me make shafa'ah with this Al-Abd al-Mu'min. Allahu Akbar. Then the reciting of Al-Quran, the recitation of Al-Quran, Qira'at Al-Quran, will make same thing. Ay Rabbi, oh my Lord, لَقَدْ مَنَعْتُهُ النَّوْمَ بِاللَّيْلِ. I have forbidden him to sleep at night. فَشَفِّعْنِي فِيهِ. Let me help. Let me make shafa'ah. Let me defend this Al-Abd al-Mu'min. يوم التناد. Imagine that. We are in the scenes of Al-Akhirah, and you find Al-Siyam, fasting, reciting of Al-Quran, are defending you in front of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, in front of Al-Khalaiq, the creations of Allah. Ah, my dad was encouraging me in dunya to recite Al-Quran and to memorize. It's too much for me. Okay, just imagine that day. The reciting of the Quran will come to defend you. Yeah. You got effort in dunya. Wallahi, you will see it at al-akhirah. You will see it. You will see it and you will live it in al-akhirah. يوم التناد. Allahu Akbar. My dear brothers and sisters, we have to imagine all these scenes. Just this is one side. From the sides of Al-Akhirah. Just one side. 10 scenes. Allah will call the messengers. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will call the disbelievers. Allah will call the believers. Now three. Then disbelievers, people of hellfire, will talk with the angels. Will talk with Malik, the head of angels, and they will talk to each other, and they will talk to their limbs. Allahu Akbar. And they will talk with a shaitan, and they will talk with people of Jannah, and people of Jannah will talk with angels, and Al-Quran wa Siyam will call the believers. 10 calls in this only side of the Day of Judgment. Imagine other sides. Imagine that day. 50,000 sana, 50,000 years. The Day of Judgment is equal 50,000 day. 50,000 years. Just one day. The Day of Al-Akhirah. 50,000 sana. Allahu Akbar. Then after that, Allah told Rasulullah, فَاصْبِرْ صَبْرًا جَمِيلًا إِنَّهُمْ يَرَوْنَهُ بَعِيدًا وَنَرَاهُ قَرِيبًا. اصْبِرْ صَبْرًا جَمِيلًا. Have a beautiful patience. إِنَّهُمْ يَرَوْنَهُ بَعِيدًا. They think that it's far away from them. وَنَرَاهُ قَرِيبًا. It's very close. The Day of Judgment is very close. وَنَرَاهُ قَرِيبًا. Allah said, may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gather us with al-anbiya, wa-siddiqeen, wa-shuhada, wa-saliheen, wa-hasuna ula'ika rafiqa. There is one sister passed away, Sister Safiya Salama Ramadan, the mother of our brother Ziyad Abdul Razzaq. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forgive her. Amen. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala have mercy upon her. Innahu ala kulli shay'in qadir. Allahumma aghfir lana dhunubana wa israfana fi amrina وثبت أقدامنا وانصرنا على القوم الكافرين. اللهم اغفر لنا ما قدمنا وما أخرنا وما أسررنا وما أعلنا وما أنت أعلم به منا. أنت المقدم وأنت المؤخر، لا إله إلا أنت. اللهم اجمعنا مع الأنبياء والصديقين والمرسلين والصالحين في الفردوس الأعلى من الجنات برحمتك يا رب الأرض والسماوات. وأقم الصلاة إن الصلاة كانت على المؤمنين كتابا موقوتا.